Good morning, caregivers. I am Carol Howell, your internationally certified dementia practitioner, Amazon best-selling author of the book, Let's Talk Dementia, and I welcome you to Let's Talk Dementia Live on Facebook. Boy, I just got back in from walking and I got the itchies. I'm glad that you're here. Happy Monday. I hope you had a good weekend. I would like to thank our sponsors who finance our ministry or help to finance our ministry. That would be Beth Crosby at editorbeth.com. Contact her for anything that you are producing that has words that you need her eyeballs on to make sure that you are representing yourself in the best way possible. HD Imports on Flint Street Extension in Rock Hill, South Carolina, 803-985-0985. Contact them for your Honda, Hyundai, Acura, Toyota, and Kia maintenance and repair. If you live anywhere near there, you'll be glad you contacted them. And Life in the Carolinas, the award-winning television show, and you can find them on YouTube and at www.lifeinthecarolinas.com. Well, today I've got so many things on my mind, I'm trying to decide which ones I'm going to share with you, but I think I've got it figured out, and then I'll share some extras tomorrow. But I wanted to mainly talk with you today about offering the fruits of the Spirit, let me get my notes here, to your loved one. Well, not just to your loved one. Now, let's think about that. Shouldn't we offer that to everybody we know? You know, I tell folks, if you spend time with me learning the techniques that I teach for good caregiving and you employ them in your life with your children or your husband or your employer, your friends, whomever, then, you know, I think life's better, because how we treat our loved ones with dementia when we do it properly really does change their world, but it changes ours too in a very good way. Well, I was thinking recently and reading a blog I had written some time ago about when we were coming to Florida regularly to visit, and we would rent a car. And we'd get down here and we'd have picked up our rental car, and we decided to go out to eat, or this particular time we'd gone to Target, and we came out of Target and we could not remember what color our dang car was. Because see, every time we came, we'd get a different car and a different color. And one time we had school bus yellow. That had to be the ugliest car. It was easy to find, though. I told my husband, as much as I complained about it, after the time when we couldn't find our car, from then on out, tell them you want the ugliest car they got on the lot so you can find it. But you're standing there thinking, what color car did we rent? I don't know. And I'm going, push the button. Maybe something will light up and we can find our car in the parking lot. Well, we did. And fortunately, it did a little beep beep and we figured out where it was. But there we stood, not being able to find our car. One time I was coming out of Walmart, and I had parked my car with great big signs on each door that said, Let's Talk Dementia. Which, P.S., those signs destroyed the paint on my car. You know, those magnetic signs, I'm never doing that again. But anyway, they were on there at that time. Let's Talk Dementia. And it's raining, and I've got a buggy full of groceries. I can't find my dang car nowhere. And so finally, there was this individual that pulled up, and I waved him down, and I said, if you're riding around and you see a Honda Fit that says, Let's Talk Dementia, will you just drive back and tell me? He looks at me and goes, yeah, right, lady. Like, you are crazy. Which I did feel kind of funny, considering what my car said. But, you know, I'd gone in the right-hand door at Walmart and came out the left-hand door. Well, all that made me think of, that's just a taste of what it feels like to have dementia and to be very confused. And you've exhausted the efforts and the ideas you had to fix this problem, and you still haven't fixed the problem. You know, what are you going to do to fix the problem? And that's a little taste of what dementia is like. And I do mean a little taste. But what I have realized that in the process of caring for folks with dementia, your LOs, that what we want to do is to extend to them the fruits of the Spirit. And what are the fruits of the Spirit? Well, I can never say this without reading it, so I'm just going to read it to you. I need to memorize this fully. But from Galatians 5, 22 and 23, it tells us, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Well, you know what? That just sounds like an excellent recipe for good dementia caregiving for me. You know, if you're kind and you're patient and you're calm and you're sweet and tender and understanding and gentle with your LO, then their life is better and so is yours. But if you extend all of those things to the rest of the people in your world, well, then you've affected a lot of people in a very positive way. And I think the more time we spend trying to share those traits with other people, the more quickly they come forth from us when we're working with our loved ones who have issues in their life that they cannot help. There's nothing they can do to make it better. I know my mom would have days when she would say, Pookie, what are we going to do to fix this? And I'd be like, Mama, if there was one thing, just one thing we could do to fix it, I would be figuring out the very best I knew how to make that one thing happen. Whoops, I hit my phone. Sorry about that. But there was nothing I could do to fix this problem for her. And that's the situation that you're in. But what we can do is everything we can in our day-to-day life to bring calm and peace to them. I can guarantee you one thing. You write this one down and tell us, Carol said this. This is gospel. If you're uptight and you're tense and you're angry and you're agitated or you're not feeling good for whatever reason, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, your loved one's not going to feel good either. It's going to have a dramatic effect on them. The more that we display the fruits of the Spirit, the better we're going to feel. And I'm going to tell you that's the truth. Now, I'm going to tell you something else that's going to help you feel better. And I have really come to realize this just in the past 4 or 5 days. As you guys know, we're dealing with a little bit of stress in our world, having just moved, and everything we own now is in Florida, and we're very happy about that. But we are not young little whippersnappers like the last time we moved, and it is work, and it has been very exhausting for us to go through this process of moving. Well, hallelujah, every box is unpacked and things are on the wall and life is organized, so that's good. But then remember, just a couple months ago, my mama went to heaven. On May 31st, my world changed forever. So I've had that, and I've had grief to deal with that hits me in weird waves throughout the day. You know, it's just kind of like this flowing along and everything, and then you hit this wave of grief, and you're like, well, what the heck made me cry now? I don't know, but there are those things. But I have really quickly learned that if I get up and walk and start my day outside with some sunshine, it really does affect how I feel the rest of the day. I became very aware of this on Saturday morning and Sunday morning. Friday and Saturday are our 2 days to sleep late. I did get up and walk Friday. Sunday morning, we're at church at 8 o'clock in the morning. I don't know who decided to have early worship at 8 o'clock. So anyway, those particular days, we did not get up early and go walk. And I can tell you, yesterday all day, I just felt kind of droopy because we'd gotten up early, but we went to church. So I know that getting out and walking helps to deal with grief and those things that you deal with. Well, I wanted to introduce you to somebody. Y'all see this? I call this my mama bear. And I've hesitated to show it to you because I'm not sure what some of you are going to think, but heck, you all think I'm crazy anyway, so there you go. Well, this mama bear is a bear that I bought for my mama for her Valentine's gift this year. And I was in Florida on Valentine's, and when I went to Walgreens, they had these super soft, really neat bears marked down to 69 cents. Uh-huh. So now I love my mama more than 69 cents worth, but I decided to pick her up one, and I took it back. In the last 24 days of her life, she held the hand of this bear just as tight as she could. And there were a couple times we had to get her to let go of it to change her clothes. And we literally had to pry the bear from her hand. She held it the whole time. Well, right now this bear is wearing a shirt that I made from one of my mama's shirts, wearing my mama's glasses, wearing my mama's ring as a bracelet, because you know my mama loved her some jewelry. And this particular shirt has beads built in. Can you see? I've got to go this way. That kind of looks like a necklace. But the other thing that makes this real special is inside this heart are some of my mama's ashes. Now, I don't know what you think about that, but you know, I don't really care either, not being mean, because this is my thing. This is what Carol did, because this is my mama bear, and I can hold it, and I can think about that I got part of my mama right here with me. That makes me feel good. So I don't know in your world if you've made plans for anything like that. There are people who make these bears out of the clothes that your loved one wears, but I was able to just to use the bear that we had. And this shirt is so tight that this bear can't breathe, but I got it. Isn't that cute? It's just cute, isn't it? It really is. So I put the my mama's glasses on this bear, and my husband said, the bear said, now I can finally see. Yeah, kind of neat. Well, that's just my thought. That's my mama bear. Thought I'd share that with you. I tell y'all everything else. Tomorrow we're going to talk about washcloths. Yeah, I got something to tell you about washcloths. I just think it's so cool. Well, I thank you for joining me here on Let's Talk Dementia. Always write me and tell me what's on your mind. I'm happy to hear from you. If you need me to call you, just send me your phone number. I'll give you a ringy-ding. And the email is carol@letstalkdementia.org. A special thanks to HD Imports for their sponsoring and their financing of our ministry as we reach people all over the world. And you can find them at where are they located? Flint Street Extension, that's it, in Rock Hill, South Carolina, 803-985-0985. The award-winning television show, Life in the Carolinas, at lifeinthecarolinas.com, and also Editor Beth at editorbeth.com. Well, as I mentioned to you last week, our show will soon be available on Roku and on Amazon Fire Stick, and I'm very excited about that. I'm working with the company to get all that up and running, and I'll keep you posted on that. But we have viewers of this show in 4 countries, and our podcast is in 75 countries. So we're excited to be sharing God's goodness and good dementia caregiving with a whole lot of people. All right, you turkeys, I'll see y'all tomorrow at 8 o'clock, and I'll tell you what I'm thankful for then, and at 8:15 for Let's Talk Dementia Live on Facebook. Now go love somebody. Bye. See you tomorrow.